And welcome back to Scale Me Down. I'm Matthew, and in this episode we're going to build and review this lightweight version 3 Hobby King Lancaster bomber. And to explain why we chose this particular model, I'm going to hand over to my wife, Gwen.
Hi, my name is Gwen, and this is a model of the Lancaster that my grandfather, flight engineer, was shot down in during the Second World War. The information for this aircraft came primarily from the book Evader in the appendix section, where we got all the details from what happened on the night in question. The aircraft itself is a Tony Nyhouse model. It flies fairly well, but it does fly a little bit heavy because of the scale details that we added to it.
Now we have all the bits out of the box, we can have a look at her. And this Hobby King Lancaster is the version 3. And earlier versions were a little bit heavier as they had retracting landing gear and movable rudders. This just has fixed vertical stabilisers and it's a hand launch and belly lander. And we've seen from the Hobby King site that it flies quite adequately on two motors. So we're actually going to put it on a further crash diet. We're going to remove the two outboard motors and speed controllers. And we're going to look to see if we can save weight anywhere else to try and make this fly as slowly as possible and with the best handling and manners as possible.
We'll start by changing the stickers whilst we can put all the parts flat on the table. I was hoping that they'd peel off, but we ended up having to overpaint them instead. To save weight, we removed the outboard motors and propellers, the tail wheel and linkage, the rear Velcro strap arrangement in the rear bomb bay compartment, and a large piece of lead ballast out of the nose. This is all easily reversible should we change our minds in the future. And now a brief montage of the simple assembly process.
And there we are, she's all finished, in her new squadron coats and a bit of sympathetic weathering. And it took about an hour, maybe a couple of hours, just to put it all together. It's very simple. Let's have a look now what she weighs, with a 1300mAh battery ready for flight, and how much weight we actually saved with the modifications.
All up weight ready for flight then is just under 900 grams, so that's a 17% reduction in weight. Let's get over to the flying field and see how she flies. A At first glance, she looks to fly alright, although a little bit quick to be realistic. There's plenty of power on hand to deliver a very scale-like performance, despite removing two motors. The control throws and centre of gravity seem about right. Control harmony seems quite nice. I prefer the way an aerodynamic rudder works, but the differential thrust works adequately well. Let's gain some height and investigate the stall. Oh dear, straight to the spin then, with not much warning. Still, when I released the elevator pressure, she recovered within half a turn. I repeated the stall test a number of times during the flight, but with the same result each time. After a 6 minute flight, the 1300 mAh battery pack had 28% charge remaining.
Well, she flew, but not well enough for my liking. I think she flew a bit quick. And we got her down nice and safely to a safe landing. Sadly, we didn't quite get the landing on camera, but we'll get the next one. I think the reason it doesn't fly too well is because of a poor choice in wing section. And for such a lumbering, slow-flying model like this, you'd expect a very flat bottom to the wing section, or even maybe slightly under-cambered. You'll notice this is almost symmetrical and the wing section is very curved underneath. So to remedy this, I've made these small fixed flap sections from a sheet of styrene. I've sprayed the inside matte black before I glue them on to make that job a little easier. And I've glued these styrene wedges on, and these are going to fit on the trailing edges to increase the incidence at the root in relation to the tip. They should generate a little bit more lift at slow speed to help slow it down a little, and it might just help tame that vicious stall.
I'm also going to grind these blisters off the undersides of the wings. I don't quite know what they're for, but they're certainly not helping the aerodynamics.
A bit like that. Unfortunately, the underside of this aeroplane is matte black, so it's dead easy to make alterations and make them look like they've always been there.
Back to the field then, and let's try again. Let's see if our modifications have tamed the stall at all. Well, a bit. It does now stall at a lower speed and recovers quicker from the ensuing spin. I think I could have made those flap surfaces a bit bigger. She also does fly a little slower now, and looks a lot more realistic as a result. I think there's still room for some improvements to be made, but in any case, I think we'll have a lot of fun with this aircraft over the summer.
So, conclusions then. We've had great fun putting this aeroplane together, and I'm really glad we made the modifications that we did. However, I think we need to go a little bit further. Out of the box, I'd say that this model is still quite poor because of the poor choice of wing section, lack of washout and that kind of thing, and I think it flies a bit too fast. That said, we've reduced the weight, which has helped a little, and put the fixed flap sections under the trailing edge, and that's helped a little as well. I think before the next flight, I might try introducing some washout to the wingtips, perhaps raising the ailerons a little bit to help also, and increasing the size of the outboard fixed flap sections. Other than that, it's been great fun, and with some modifications, has great potential. As ever, please like and subscribe to support the channel, and I'll pop a few affiliate links in the description below. We'll see you next time.